Hey guys, it's Shahbaz here. And today, I'll be showing you how to make a single bracelet. Not with a charm, my next one will be with a charm. Like, you know, these kind of charms. That are like these, and they come in packs or something. Yeah, so I'll be showing you how to make just a regular single bracelet. So I will be doing a three color pattern bracelet, 1, 2, 3. And I would recommend setting it like this, just like I did right now. But just like I did right now. But I will show you how I did it. Wait a second. Okay, so yeah, this is how I set it up. I'll show you. Here's how it looks like. So my pattern's gonna be yellow, blue, orange. So I set up in that pattern, like see, yellow, blue, orange. So I recommend doing like that since it's gonna be easier for you then. So yeah, I'd really recommend doing it like that. So yeah, let's just get started. So the supplies you will need is your loom, any kind of loom, because you'll need it in standard position, not in rows or anything else. So you can use any kind of loom you want. You're gonna need your hook. Oh, and if you're probably like how to design or anything, just check out my tutorial. It's gonna probably be on the side of this video, or it might be on my channel. It's gonna say Shahbaz Royal how to make a design for your hook, and you'll see how to make it like this. And you'll need, you know, about, if you're like my age, or like, you know, my kind of wrist, let me just show you how it is. Oh yeah, by the way, this is called a lifesaver bracelet. It was made by someone, I don't know if they wanted their name said on YouTube, but they invented it. It's like, with that cap and everything, and the back is like this. But yeah, so if you have a wrist like me, just basically like a star wrist bracelet and like 3 rubber bands, then you would need about 20 rubber bands. And if you're older than me, then, or have a bigger wrist than me, then you're gonna need more than that. So let's just get started. So you're gonna need your arrows pointing away from you. And now you need to get your first color, which mine's going to be yellow. Yeah, and put it from this bottom peg. You can do it to the left or right. I'm gonna be doing it to the right. Now take your next color, put it from this peg to this peg. Now I'm going to take my last color design that I'm doing only 3. And you can copy my design or you don't have to. I wish the thing would go up. But yeah. I'm going to put it from this peg to this peg. So now I'm going to start my design again. So you're going to go from this peg to this peg. Push it down. You don't have to push down that much because it's not like it's a bracelet with a lot of like stuff on the same side going to it. So you don't really have to. There, so it should be like this. And now this. So now, this is the last time I showed you, so just, so now what you will do is you're just gonna, like, put it not until the end of, well, how much your wrist is, so probably some people will be right here, some people will be right here, and some people will be up till the end. I'm not gonna be up till the end, I'm gonna be a little before the end. So yeah, just now we're gonna start again. Go ahead.
Do you ever feel already buried deep?
Okay, guys, so now you should have finished. Yeah, I'm just gonna be on my last peg, and now, yeah, just be until the last one. There. So now your loom, how much your design, how much your wrist is, should be filled. See how I did it up till right here? So I was a little farther away from here. So that's about my size. So yeah, let's just get started on looping. Okay, so your loom's gonna be like this, but you need to turn around so you can loop now. So now the arrow should be pointing you, or you should have upside down U peg. So now you're gonna skip your first straw band right here. Like you see this orange, I'm not gonna loop from here, and I'm not gonna put a cap band, remember that. This is basically gonna be your cap band. So now you're just gonna get this color that's right in front of it. Now loop it to the left. Now you're gonna take your next color and try to make sure that your rub bands don't get wrinkled as you're looping it. Like if they do, I mean, that's not bad. But that kind of is, because your bracelet will get a little more less better. Okay. So now you're gonna loop it again up till here. See how my kind of wrinkled? I'm just gonna try to make it not wrinkled. Wait. Oh yeah, yours has to wrinkle sometime, and definitely. But if you have fungal bands, oh yeah, if you have fungal bands, I don't think they do. Because they're a little more less stretchy. But I think it's because of the stretchiness, that's why they wrinkle. Now this is the last time I will be showing you. Alright, so now finish it until the end of the loom. Okay, so just finish until the end of the loom and stop there.
Thank you.
Okay, guys, so you guys, if you should have finished by now, up till the end of the loom. And this rubber band right here should be in a triangle. Yeah. And now it's time to take it off, but you're gonna now put here's your rubber band. Now you're just gonna put it through there, your hook, and it should be like this now. Now take the next rubber band. I'm gonna do blue, the light blue that I did, because that's the next in the pattern. Actually, I'm gonna do orange. And it's gonna match with my cat band. Okay, so now since you have done your cat band, now it's gonna take it off. Okay, so now here's since you have done that with your hook, now you're gonna put it here and dare you to watch it, like, take it off. It might be wrinkled, but it shouldn't be. Turned out better than my last bracelet. Okay, so it should be like a single now, and your last supposed to be cap end is gonna be like this. And now you're gonna take an S clip or any kind of clip you have. Since I had a fun loom, I got those awesome C clips, and I mean they're awesome. But I don't like to waste them on, you know, these kind of regular easy bracelets. So I'm gonna be using S clips, or you can use C clips. That's what I would recommend. Not those humongous C clips. Because you should use those on big bracelets. Okay, so now you're just gonna, the part that's on the hook, you won't need it. If you need an extension, you can, I don't know. Single bracelets allows you to wear it. Okay, so, well, unless you're doing this long and you're really old. Okay, now just attach it to the clip. So now that part is attached, and I'm gonna attach this cap band. Okay, so now your bracelet is done. Now you have a single bracelet. So guys, thanks for watching. This is and please this is Shahbaz, but please thumbs up and subscribe. And guys, this is Shahbaz and